With blind devotion to President Trump, Senator Lindsey Graham again proving himself as one of the president's most reliable frontmen.
Is this whistleblower, whoever he or she may be, do they have any connection to the intelligence community, the old intelligence community that was corrupt as hell?
Graham has fallen in line behind President Trump and become the face of Trump's defense on Capitol Hill.
To impeach any president over a phone call like this would be insane.
That stance a stunning about-face, given his position on impeachment during the Clinton years.
You don't even have to be convicted of a crime to lose your job in this constitutional republic. If this body determines that your conduct as a public official is clearly out of bounds in your role, impeachment is about cleansing the office. Impeachment is about restoring honor and integrity to the office.
It hasn't always been this way. The Graham of today,
I have the president's back because I think this is a setup,
is a far cry from the Graham of just a few years ago.
You know how you make America great again? Tell Donald Trump to go to hell.
Known then for slamming Trump during the campaign.
He's a race-baiting, xenophobic, religious bigot. He doesn't represent my party.
And at times going against him, even admitting he urged Senator McCain to turn over the controversial Steele dossier of Trump Russia allegations to the FBI. But in the last year, Graham has strategically cozied up to the president. The two golf and speak on the phone often.
We have a man who has become a friend of mine. It's shocking, isn't it?
I like him and he likes him.
Graham has a lot to gain politically in hitching his wagon to Trump. The senator is up for re-election in South Carolina in 2020, where standing with the president only stands to help his own political future.
And Graham in the past has attempted to justify his own transformation in very raw political terms, telling the New York Times Magazine earlier this year that his friendship with Trump helps him. It helps him influence Trump on issues that he cares about. And Graham says that anyone who knows him would think it's odd if he did not do this. And asked a follow-up by the reporter what this means, Graham replied, to try to be relevant. Jake.
Try to be relevant. Sunlen Serfaty on Capitol Hill. Thanks so much. Dana Bash, you know Senator Graham pretty well. Is that it? Is that what it's about? Being relevant, staying relevant, even if it means sacrificing many things that a lot of people thought he stood for?
That's a big part of it. And he is very open about it. He wants to be relevant. He wants to be part of the conversation. He wants to try to influence the conversation. But for so many years, when we covered him on the Straight Talk Express and in post John McCain elections and events, being relevant and being part of the conversation was standing in the opposite corner of the Republican Party. But what he has slowly but very surely come to realize, and the way that he is acting and behaving right now, is that the Republican Party is Donald Trump. And he wants to stay a Republican, and so he is going to be a major part of the Trump Republican Party. The other Lindsey Graham, the Lindsey Graham who was, you know, one part of the Three Amigos with John McCain, be damned. And one other thing I just want to point out is that it's not just that. It is, as Sunlen talked about, it is South Carolina. He calls South Carolina Trumpistan. As much as he gets, you know, guff from people who say, wait a minute, what happened to you? When he goes home to South Carolina, he is greeted as a hero because they, for the most part, love Donald Trump and love him standing next to him.
And you can go back to the 90s, to the Clinton impeachment, and find clips of people like Gerald Nadler and Nancy Pelosi saying the exact opposite thing about impeachment that they're saying today. Mm-hmm. But we can also do that on the Republican side. And since we're talking about Lindsey Graham, take a listen to Lindsey Graham's definition of impeachment when it applied to Bill Clinton, and he was a House impeachment manager.
Impeachment is not about punishment. Impeachment is about cleansing the office. Impeachment is about restoring honor and integrity to the office.
It's kind of what people hate about politics, right? That principles only apply when they want to apply them to the other party.
Yeah, you know, to pick up on what we were just talking about a moment ago, I mean, this is an advertisement for term limits. This guy comes from a place that is South Carolina, that Dana Bash says this is Trumpistan. That is, Lindsey Graham is not necessarily sitting around. A lot of us know him from the green room. He's a decent guy. He's thoughtful. He's not exactly sitting around saying, what's the perfect thing to do? He's sitting around saying, what do the people in my state say? in how do I get reelected, in my judgment. He doesn't have to campaign in New York. He doesn't have to campaign in California. He's got to campaign in South Carolina. So I look at this and say, Lindsey Graham looked at the documents, the polling documents from South Carolina, and said, I know where to line up if I want a job forever. And that's what he's got.
The Republican Party, as Dana was saying earlier, is the Trump Party. If you think about the people who have spoken out against President Trump, even if they have really strong conservative credentials, think about Justin Amash, who was basically kicked out of the party, even though he has been conservative, has been libertarian, scores very high on all of these various outside groups' report cards. He was kicked out of the party because he said negative things about President Trump. So anybody in the Republican Party who's not willing to defend the president, who's not willing to go along with the president's even most vulgar attributes, they're going to be kicked out of the party. And Lindsey Graham knows that, and that's part of the reason he's made this choice.
It is a very, very different thing to go along with the president because you want to be relevant and because it is politically viable for you in your home state. Still, again, back to the Lindsey Graham with John McCain that we knew, especially on this issue of Ukraine. I mean, how many times did we listen to John McCain and Lindsey Graham talk about how critical it is to prop up Ukraine and to not play politics with it because Ukraine was the way to fight Putin? And the fact that this is the issue is stunning.
Look, Kim, I want to get your legal take on something that Lindsey Graham has been pushing, which is this whole argument. It's been discredited by the Inspector General of the intelligence community that the whistleblower only has hearsay. The Inspector General said he has firsthand information as well as second and thirdhand information. But Lindsey Graham's been pushing the hearsay argument. Take a listen.
This seems to me like a political setup. It's all hearsay. You can't get a parking ticket conviction based on hearsay.
Is that true?
No, that's not true. Hearsay is admissible in evidence under the federal rules of evidence. There are some exceptions that get it admissible. But in this instance, the statute itself doesn't require firsthand knowledge. We know from the Inspector General that there was firsthand knowledge. And in any event, this is handed off in this moment to the Congress. So the whistleblower, the credibility of this whistleblower was evaluated by the Inspector General, a Trump appointee, and is really not an issue anymore. The whistleblower is not the issue. The issue is President Trump. So clearly his political team wants to divert American attention to other issues. But in this moment, I would take one issue with this idea that Lindsey Graham is supporting his base, in that falsehoods are not good for anyone, regardless of where you are politically.